stinging from the loss to Batista at Armageddon. He laid down the law to Rosa Manu earlier on.
Is Orton focused or what? Look at those eyes. He is seething.
Said this legacy's over unless we can make some sort of impact tonight. Did we fail? Tried to take out Batista last night, failed earlier on tonight as well.
Sports, when I look at him, he's just those eyes, that stare, he's almost serpent-like.
This is Monday Night Raw. This is our main event. Live in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, the world champion John Cena, a former world champion Batista on the same team against former world champion Randy Orton, Cody Rhodes, and Manu.
Oh, what a match this is going to be.
Randy Orton, a premeditated, calculated ambush earlier tonight of Batista. Had Batista right where he wanted him, three-on-one situation, before John Cena got involved. And remember what these three men did to John Cena 2 weeks ago right here on Raw King. The assault of Cena over in the technical area. The RKO on the concrete floor. Randy Orton, third generation superstar. Manu and Rhodes, second generation stars. Going for the Batista bomb.
Boom.
Randy Orton using Manu as a battering ram. And from out of nowhere, the RKO. WWE officials trying to admonish Randy Orton, but
Orton just directing traffic.
Look at the assault on Cena.
He's ordering an assault there on John Cena. Manu and Cody Rhodes keeping Cena at bay. Wait a minute.
No. No, look at the eyes, look at the expression change in Randy Orton. Batista is in trouble.
No! No! Orton with a punt. To the temple of Batista.
Viper struck again.
Dave, I think Batista's unconscious.
Martin's proud of himself. Apparently the legacy. This legacy is alive and well.
Be proud of doing something like that. Those kicks of the concussions and really ending people's careers.
And I thought Batista was going to end this thing with a Batista bomb, but we saw Orton using Manu as a battering ram and then delivering that vicious RKO.
Everything was completely out of control at this point. And Orton would sit Manu and Rhodes on Cena, leaving Batista to
watch this again. Look, oh my God. File punt right to the temple.
Oh, just sickening. Randy Orton wanted impact.
Batista. He's stirring and he's conscious.
Missouri, weighing 245 pounds, Randy Orton.
My Undertaker, you said he's got to be satisfied. As much as I know about Randy Orton, I don't think he's ever satisfied.
Randy Orton was bitter over the fact that he lost to Batista at Armageddon, but it's more deep-rooted than that. It goes back years to when Randy Orton and Batista were part of the group Evolution. Many close to Randy Orton says that he's always been jealous of Batista. He never got over everything Batista's accomplished.
But the ironic part about that is Randy Orton claims to this very day that Batista, and not only Batista, but Triple H and Ric Flair were all jealous of him when they were in Evolution.
Randy Orton set for the next match here in the Race to the Rumble tonight. Already advancing.
Well, you're right. Shawn Michaels has advanced with a win over Kane. And then we saw JBL advance with a disqualification win over Rey Mysterio, thanks to Shawn Michaels.
Well, what kind of condition, however, is Batista going to be in for this matchup?
You saw that sickening, an absolutely sickening impact on Batista's temple. The hands of Randy Orton with that punt last week.
Ladies and gentlemen, Batista is unable to appear here tonight. Therefore, the winner of this match as a result of a forfeit, Randy Orton.
Michael, you and I had speculated about this early on. It's really not a surprise to me. I don't know how anyone could have recovered from that kick this fast.
I have had many memorable moments throughout my career. Being the youngest world heavyweight champion in history, winning the main event of this year's WrestleMania. But nothing is as personally satisfying as when I kicked Batista in the skull last week. Four years ago, I won my first world title in this very arena, in fact. But the next day, Batista, seething with jealousy, hoisted me up on his shoulders in celebration, but then dropped me back flat down on the mat and ambushed me. I have been dreaming about kicking Batista in the skull for the last 4 years. Same dream every night, 4 straight years. And then last week it finally happened. Christmas came early. So how does it feel, Dave? How does it feel to know that you won't be facing Cena at the Royal Rumble? How does it feel to have your career cut short? 4 years ago, you were in Evolution, and now you've come full circle. You're right back at the exact same place you started, taking a back seat to me. You did it to yourself, Batista. You had your time, and your time is over. And the next time that you'll see me, I will once again be the World Heavyweight Champion.
I hear voices in my head, they count to me.
Absolutely no remorse.
Oh.
Randy Orton saying that Christmas came early with the realization of a four-year dream when he punted Dave Batista in the temple, and then doesn't take any blame for it on himself. Says, Dave, you did it to yourself. Unbelievable.
Well, what it means, however, is Randy Orton has advanced in the race to the Rumble. Orton winning tonight over Batista via forfeit because of the punt last week to the head of the Batista, and we now know that three men have advanced to next week's fatal four-way elimination matchup on Monday Night Raw.
Shawn Michaels advances with the win over Kane, and then, of course, JBL.